Yeah, they said it, but I said it first. So in a sense, I take these niggas birth. That's why my fans in my show screaming, take me to church. No suit and tie, but baby, I go to work. Don't do it for the money, but that's one of the perks. If y'all got the shovel, then I got the dirt.
Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. You might notice a couple things different about this video. So I'm actually wearing my glasses because, well, we're outside and I feel like my glasses either have a glare or make my eyes look really dark when I record inside, even with the ring light. So I don't wear them when I film inside. But today I am filming outside because guess what happened this morning? At 4 o'clock, my boyfriend and I woke up to our kitchen being flooded because there is a foundation leak in our building that they tried to fix with spray foam insulation. And it leaked onto our carpet. And usually I sit on the carpet to film over by the kitchen. And it's still wet there, even though they have a giant industrial fan blowing on it to dry. So we are likely moving once the lease is up because this has been an ongoing issue. But anyways, this video, as it's titled, is Millennial Goes Back to Church. As you all probably know, I am a millennial. I was born in 29, and I'm going to talk about my story of growing up in the church, then leaving the church, and then finally deciding to go back to church in November of 2018. So enough with my rambling and nonsense, I'm going to get started. So a lot of articles have pointed out that millennials have been going to church less frequently and the church is concerned about this. And what a lot of millennials are looking for in a church is they want to feel welcome, they want to feel like the message is being presented in a way that seems real and genuine and relatable and just easy to understand as to why it applies to their life. So as I already mentioned before, I started going back to church in November of 2018, and I was raised in the Catholic Church, and I now attend a non-denominational church. And as a kid, I really loved church because we had a priest that at one of the churches I went to, he knew how to make the sermons lively and very relatable. He always used different stories and personal examples to relate to a scripture we were talking about in the Bible and the importance of applying those principles to our lives, which I thought was great. But then we moved and we went to two different churches where we didn't feel welcome because we had not been part of that community since birth. So at those churches, we would get a lot of judgment and a lot of dirty looks, which I never felt was right. Like, I felt like you should be able to walk into a church and feel welcome because God wants, you know, all people to feel welcome in His kingdom. So one of the churches in particular that I attended in high school, which really made me, like, kind of question and lose my faith, went to an Easter Mass at this church. And from what me and my parents and my siblings got from it, it was less eventful and joyous than a funeral, if you know what I mean. Like, they basically just spoke in monotone, droned on in a way that just really didn't engage you. There wasn't the joy about, oh, Christ has risen, it is the resurrection, and presented in a way where you felt welcome. And on top of that, the priest actually left during Mass to perform baptism. And every other church I've gone to, usually baptisms are done in front of the church or in front of family members, so this seemed a little off. I mean, I can understand if the family wanted privacy, but they should have accommodated this differently. What happened at this church is I had actually taken my confirmation class there, and during that confirmation class, we actually had a very uncomfortable Christian sex talk where we were basically lectured about how terrible homosexuality is. We ended up having this ridiculously long debate about abortion, which was most of the class, and we also just talked about how horrible premarital sex is. And I'll eventually address some of these issues in future videos, but being raised differently and knowing people in the LGBT community and what I do now about abortion, I felt like this was very uncomfortable, and I remember being so mad and just so irritated with it. I just felt like this was not appropriate to talk about in a confirmation class, and I remember like asking my mom, I'm like, Mom, why do I have to keep going with this class? I really don't want to. This made me feel very uncomfortable. My mom just told me to just stick through it, but just knowing how judgmental and how, like, the way that people can misinterpret some scriptures and show different sides of the story just really bothered me. And like, the way I grew up was, you know, knowing that Jesus had loved everybody and wanted us to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. So again, with the whole LGBT being a sin, in fact, it doesn't straight up say that in the Bible, but once again, I'll get to that in another video. It just really, really hit a nerve with me. And after my confirmation, I felt like, oh, the cat is tapping at the window. But I just felt that I didn't belong in the church anymore, and I just stopped going. I didn't want to go. I didn't know what I believed in anymore, and I was going through just a lot of changes in my life. It was right before I got diagnosed with depression and anxiety, so I was in a really dark spot, and I felt like God couldn't save me. And then at that point, I started exploring other religions, seeing if I could follow those, and I did like the principles of some of the other religions I learned about, but deep down I felt like there was still faith in God with me. And it took several kind of soul searching, figuring things out, doing my own research, and realizing, hey, I should probably go back to church. It took my boyfriend and I a little over a year and a half to come to the conclusion that we both should start going to church. And then we found a church that we really liked, that we found identified with our values. And I actually knew a friend that used to go to that church before she moved out of state. So I went and talked to her, asked her a few questions about the church. And she said she really loved it, and she found that it had really restored her faith. So my boyfriend and I decided to go to one of their services, and we really liked it. So the sermon that we went to was about tithing or giving. However, it wasn't a sermon just telling us we have to give to the church. And our pastor even said, you know, you hear about these churches where there are pastors who have these fancy cars, mansions, what have you. But, you know, they don't have that. But they also said that if we wanted to look at where the money that goes, they had a thing on their website that we could look at. And then they even said if we didn't feel comfortable giving to the church, we could find other charities that we felt like were doing God's work and we could give to them. And that just, it felt very right to my boyfriend and I, because we could decide to give where we think God's work is being done. We do give a little bit of money here and there when we're at church. It's usually whatever cash we have on hand. And then we haven't, you know, picked out one particular charity that we want to give to yet. So we usually give to, like, small things here and there. After that service, we found that every other sermon that we went to, it seemed like our pastor presented everything in a way where it was a message of love and love for Jesus, and everything was shared in a way that made sense and was relatable. There was no shaming, no making you feel guilty. We even did a sermon about how guilt and shame are unhealthy feelings and what we can do about them. It was actually about forgiveness, and they'll actually go over like different series where they do different books in the Bible and break everything down. And for Easter, we actually did something a little bit different where they did, instead of just the resurrection, they actually did a service about why we have the resurrection, which was unique and different from anything I'd ever gone. But anyways, that's enough on me and my boyfriend deciding to go back to church and which church we decided to go to. I do want to talk about how to pick out a church for yourself if you haven't gone to church for a while. So ideally, you should decide, do you want to go to a more Orthodox church, or do you want to go to like a non-denominational church like we go to? Also, look at reviews about the church. Talk to people that go to that church. Figure out if you feel like the message is being presented in the way God intended it to, whether you think that any judgment is being passed. Also, once you've done your research and looked around for different churches, attend a service. Find out, do you feel welcome there? Do you feel wanted there? Do you like the way that the sermons are being presented? Do you feel like God's word is being presented in a way that it should be? Those are all things that you should look for when picking a church. And that's everything. As I said, I grew up in the church, but then drifted away from the church as a teenager, and it wasn't until my late 20s, when I was 28, that I had gone back to church. And now I'm at a church that I love and I look forward to going to. The only downside is now, because of the job that I work, I can't go every Sunday, but they do podcasts on their website, so I like to watch those. However, it's just not the same as physically going there, but I do what I can to get in the Word of God and spend time with God, either reading my Bible or reading devotionals, or again, watching the podcast for my church. But that's everything. Once again, I post new videos every Thursday, and be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And do not forget to hit the bell so you don't miss a notification. Bye, guys!